Hi, I'm Janek Gwizdala of VideoBasedLessons.tv, and I'm here not only to tell you about a brand new 12-part course that we just launched on VideoBasedLessons.tv today on transcription, which is pretty much the most fundamental aspect of what I do on a daily basis and what I have done over the past 15 to 20 years in terms of learning music. I'm not only here to tell you about that, which is going to be a lot of fun, but I'm also here to give you a look inside that, look behind the scenes, a look inside my process. Now, our members started this course today, and over the next three videos in this little kind of free video preview set, I'm going to give you a look inside this transcription course. I should have transcribed some English for myself, I guess, but we're transcribing music. I'm going to give you a look inside this course. We're going to look at the four, I've kind of categorized it into four main areas of how I look at a transcription when I go to learn some new music. I look at planning the music, i.e. what transcription am I going to do, what music is exciting me, what music don't I understand, what things in my playing need fixing that I can fix through transcribing some music. We're going to look at writing the music down. The older I get, the worse my memory gets. So it's, for me at least, it's essential to write this stuff down and have a note of it. And, you know, this turns into to what me and Mike Stern call the scrolls of knowledge. We both have dozens and dozens of books full of transcriptions we've made over the years. And we can, you know, it might be 10 years later after we've made that transcription, we've totally forgotten about it. And we go back and we look at that and it's like, oh man, there was such a great lick or a line or a really nice melodic phrase or something. And we can go back and be re-inspired by our own kind of mini library of vocabulary. Then the third part of the course is playing the music. Of course, we want to learn these notes. We want to get these notes so far into our playing that they become a part of us. And that's kind of a long process, especially as the transcription we're going to be working on in this course. It is a blues. It's a very simple form, but some of the aspects of it are quite technically demanding. It's an up-tempo blues. So I'm going to look at all the ways, you know, I've been doing this over the past 2 weeks myself. I transcribed the thing from start to finish. Now I learned how to play it. So I'm kind of have the first-hand experience fresh in my mind about what I did to overcome a lot of the things in the solo that I had difficulty executing on the instrument. So we're going to look at all the playing aspects of the music. And then one which might sound the final, the fourth part of the course, and one which might sound odd if you just look at the title, I call it forgetting the music. And by that, I don't mean that this has all been a waste of time and then it was just an exercise and then you move on to the next thing. By forgetting the music, I mean that in the third part of the course, we're looking at the playing aspect and getting that music so ingrained in our own playing. What I mean when I say forgetting the music is really forgetting the kind of the mechanics of it and the direct copying, like this carbon copy you made from that solo. And finding phrases from the playing section that you really like, developing those around the instrument, kind of breaking away from the solo in the form that we're gonna, the entire form that we're gonna learn this Michael Brecker solo in, and really letting that come out in your playing as a natural extension of you. So in forgetting the music, I really mean forgetting the conscious thought of that music, you know, really not thinking, okay, this is what he did in bar 18 of the third chorus and that this is a great lick, blah, blah. I really want you to forget about the solo once you get it into your playing. And you're going to find, as I have met for many, many years, you know, and it might take weeks, it might take a couple of days, sometimes it might take a year, but those phrases that you've worked so hard on in the playing kind of section of this course and of this concept are really going to come out as a natural extension of your playing and add to your unique voice as a musician, which at the end of the day is the ultimate goal. Whether you're looking at this transcription course we're starting right now today, or whether you're looking at any of the other lessons on VideoBasedLessons.tv, the goal at the end of the day for me in my playing, and I hope what I can convey to you for your playing, is to be unique, is to find your own voice at the end of the day. And for me, the transcription, like I said, the transcription aspect has been the most fundamental part of my development as a musician. Just the same as when we were born and we were immersed and surrounded by people speaking our native language, our parents when we were infants, and then we went to school and we interacted with people our age, we were constantly surrounded by people speaking this language. So there's no kind of, there are no dents in the thought process. You don't have to go, you don't have to go, to construct that sentence, you don't have to go and think about it. You don't have to have it disconnected like that. You can immediately dial up, you don't have to go and think about it. And it can be very natural, it can be very flowing. And that's always what I'm heading for and what I'm aiming for with the music. So I want you to take a quick look at me playing along with the recording, just the first couple of choruses of the solo to give you a taste of where we're going, what kind of material we're going to be getting out of this solo. And we'll come back after we check that out, and I'll start talking about a few of the fundamental aspects that I got out of these first couple of choruses of this Michael Brecker solo. This is Mike Brecker live in London in 1998, live at the Barbican, with a great Joey Calderazzo on piano, James Genus is playing bass, Ralph Peterson is playing drums, and the song is a blues. Like I said before, it's actually kind of a 24 bar blues because it's a longer form. It's like a double blues form, and the song is called Delta City Blues. Inside the first couple of choruses there of the solo, and I really wanted to, by playing that along with the record, especially on an instrument that isn't a saxophone, by playing it along with the recording with the bass, I just want to highlight that this material is possible to play on any instrument. I used to think for so long I'd hear these long kind of complicated saxophone lines or guitar lines or piano lines and think, oh my god, I'll never be able to play that on the bass of all things. But then, you know, you get these lines that are completely possible. You know, they're very saxophonistic, they're quite angular, in this case they're really fast as well, so there's some technically demanding things in there, but they are totally possible to play on the bass, or on any instrument for that matter. So in terms of the rest of the planning stages and the reasons why I chose this particular solo, you know, of course I'm choosing solos all the time. I just felt this was a good one for the course. It displays a lot of different harmonic language. It's quite technically demanding. And one of the things I came across, even though I have great technique and I've been playing for so long, I've even been playing quite a lot of this kind of material for so long, I really had some difficulties with some of these phrases. They were real, they were kind of musical tongue twisters or bass players tongue twisters. I got total technical block. So not only did working on this, you know, it inspired me to work on it musically and melodically, but through the process, you know, especially in the third part of this course, the playing part, it really gave me some amazing practice time in terms of developing parts of my technique that I thought were really sound, and I poked so many holes in them and improved my playing a considerable amount in quite a short space of time. I've only been working on this solo for maybe 8 or 9 days. So in that short amount of time, I've seen progress in my playing, which after you've been playing 15 or 20 years like I have, it's kind of hard to see progress sometimes, and sometimes you feel like you're in a rut. So the planning that went into this solo really has really paid off for me in the end. And I think if you stick with it and you come on the ride with us and take this transcription course, I think you'll have a kind of a similar experience as well, especially if you're really into the music. So with the planning side of it, before I even started writing stuff down and learning the notes, a couple of points that are really important to me are listening. I listened to this solo, you know, maybe 100 times, maybe even more, for quite a few days before I even picked up the bass. It's a blues form, so in terms of knowing the form, it wasn't that difficult to grasp. It's a longer blues, it's 24 bars, the way the quarter note is, kind of a double time blues. But it's a blues nonetheless, essentially 1, 4, and 5. And in this case of a jazz blues, there are a couple of extra 2, 5, 1s in there, which we'll get into and we'll explain a little later. But basically the concept was to really listen to the form and feel where the top of the form keeps falling round and round and round. There are 7 choruses of the solo, of the Mike Brecker solo that I transcribed. This is from Michael Brecker live in London, a live concert, random live concert. The song is a Delta City Blues, like I said. And so that was really important, hearing the form. And then really, you know, the being aware of what drew me to this solo. it was that initial, that E, you know, we're in the key of B flat. And if you check below this video, you can download. I've given you the first couple of phrases in the first chorus of this, and just to show you written down, if you need to see it visually to understand what it is, I've given you that to download. And it's very simple in the beginning, the pickup. Essentially this. It's even a C minor 7 arpeggio there. C, E flat, G, and B flat. Just 1, 3, 5, 7. And we're descending, we're getting into this E, this tritone sound. And that was the initial thing. I was like, oh, that's in the very first bar of the top of the form. And not only does he stick on that E to create this tension, but he uses this whole E major pentatonic sound as well. So that was kind of what initially grabbed me to that. I was like, wow, that's what that is. You know, I really wanted to find out what it is. And after I transcribed it, I looked at it and I was like, oh, that's what it is. Let me dig deeper into this solo. Let me see what I can learn from this. And let me see how many things I can pull out and inject into my own playing. So basic immersion is probably the best way to describe it. And I always liken that to language. When we're born, we're immersed in our native language by our parents, by our grandparents, our aunts, our uncles, our relatives. And then later on in life, we grow up and we have friends of the same age and peers, and we're always immersed in this language. That's why we don't have to think about constructing a sentence. That sentence I just said, we don't have to think about constructing a sentence. That's so fluid, that's so natural to us in our native language, no matter what language we speak. And for me, it's no different with the bass, and I'm always striving for it to be no different with the bass and with music in general. So what we're going to cover, we'll be getting another couple of videos coming towards you in your inbox in a couple of days, and then a couple of days later after that, we're going to look at all four of these. I want to give you a quick look inside all four of these areas, the planning, the writing, the playing, and then the forgetting. Don't forget those four things. Planning the music, writing the music down, playing the music and learning, and then forgetting it and letting it come out naturally in your playing. That's what we're going to be looking at. Our students at videobasedlessons.tv started this course today, which I'm very excited about. I think they're pretty excited about it too. And I look forward to seeing you on the next video. We're going to talk a little bit about writing this stuff down, notating it. I know some people have some issues with notating it, and should they, shouldn't they? Should they write notes down? Should it be tablature? We're going to cover all of that. I have some pretty simple ideas for getting this information down on the paper and for remembering it and for being able to reference that information again and go back to it and be re-inspired by all this work you're doing now at a later date in the future. So I'm Janek Gwizdala. It's videobasedlessons.tv, and we'll see you on the next lesson.